down there looks like a big cleft, doesn't it, through the landscape.
My TomTom sat nav, and I put in shortest route, but I didn't put in fastest route, and it took us all over the blooming place.
Using the long stroke chug ability of the engine, I always experience a bit of joy when I find something that I've been wanting to see for a long time, and there it is. So the road open, do not stop, follow the signs, keep to the road.
Listen to that, it's hammering down. Oh.
They're all here. There's Dickie, look. There's Harry. That's Harry Enfield. There's Mandy. Yeah. So we're heading off to Welsh Wales, and we're going to the Gospel Pass. Then we're going to go round to Devil's Staircase. Then we're going to go and end up down by Lake Llyne Briane and our campsite, which is a camping and caravanning club campsite at a place called Randermwyn. So I think what I'll do, I'll bring you back when we maybe get closer to the Gospel Pass. We're in Wales now. I got Motor Man, also known as Dickie, behind me, and Harry Enfield behind him. We've got about 2.25 miles to go before we get to the Queen's Head pub. The Queen's Head pub is the more or less the beginning, if you like, or almost the beginning of the Gospel Pass. So that'd be good to ride that again. A little bit of information about the Gospel Pass. First of all, the Queen's Head pub. It's around here somewhere. The Gospel Pass is the highest, it's the highest road, if you like, in Wales, I believe. I think we're coming up to the Queen's Head pub now. So the Queen's Head pub basically is the Abergavenny side of the Gospel Pass. So from this point on, the only way is in one direction now, and that brings us up to the Gospel Pass. And I know you've got a car park there for Hay Bluff. And the other side of the Gospel Pass, coming down the other side, you'll get to see that in a minute. Absolutely stunning scenery. Anyway, I'll let you enjoy the view. We're coming out of the wooded area now, so up there, nice bit of mountainside. So I reckon we're going to be up on the pass almost at any moment. Yep, this rings bells to me when I was last here. So we're now we're now on the Gospel Pass. Let's just stop and have a word with Dickie. We're on the Gospel Pass now, Dickie. Yeah. Yeah. Nice to be back, isn't it? Yeah, yeah. It's old Harry Enfield behind me, look. Looking very dapper. Let's explore the Gospel Pass then. Oh, by the way. Happy New Year. This is the lovely view you get. Absolutely amazing. Make sure the old lens is clean. Look at that for a view. Nice view, Harry.
Yeah, beautiful.
Yeah, yeah.
Not better than Swindon.
Better than Swindon. Nice view, Dickie.
Nah.
Didn't like it. Look at that lovely view over there though.
How many miles do you reckon we can see?
Pardon?
How many miles do you reckon we can see?
Not very far. 3 or 4 mile because of the mist, isn't it? Maybe over there, maybe 8 mile maybe. But there's a... down there looks like a big cleft, doesn't it, through the landscape. Yeah. Anyway, I'll follow you.
Pull up in the car park, yeah?
Yeah. Well, this is the car park at the other end of the pass now, so we're almost off the Gospel Pass now. So stop here and then plan the route going forward to all our campsite. The adventure continues. We followed the sat nav. There's a sign over there which says unsuitable for motor vehicles, and oh, we've got to find a different route. Possibly make it along there, but possibly not.
Glad to say, finally arrived. Got a bit damp, it rained for the last sort of half hour of our journey. I was following my my TomTom sat nav, and I put in shortest route, but I didn't put in fastest route, and it took us all over the blooming place. There's Harry, look. You speak to the furry thing and you look at the glass thing.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
Well, we can't get lost anymore, can we?
No, that's. This is Harry Enfield.
Good run down though. I enjoyed that run. It was.
Yeah, it's great.
Couldn't you find some narrower roads?
No, I couldn't. It was perfect, wasn't it? Yeah, and we're all on it. We're all on the Himalayans.
You've never done it on the biggies.
No, yeah. No. This is Dickie, look.
We'd have been through the hedge, wouldn't we, if we'd been on the old bigger bikes?
Yeah. We'd have done a Colin, wouldn't we?
Yeah.
Yeah. So Dickie, yeah.
Hello. Happy New Year. Well, won't be long for the next one, until the next one.
I know. Well, yeah.
I could say it all over again for the rest of the year.
Happy New Year. Yeah. So Dickie's bought himself a new tent.
New tent.
Handy. Burgess Grampian. Lovely tent. Nice and dark inside. Yeah, so, yeah, I think he'll sleep well in there.
Bit different for me, little banshee, isn't it? I wear that.
You wear your banshee, but that, you know, like a hotel room.
That banshee would have been up within about 5 minutes.
I'm in the MSR Elixir 2, got the Trangier on, boil in the bag curry, that's... down there warming up nicely, and that's my setup, and we're right next to a river. There's a lovely river down there. Well, the plan of action this morning is to head off to see the reservoir Llyne Briane, or Llyne Briane, and then we're going to do Devil's Staircase and then to see where the road takes us, hopefully ending up at Aberystwyth for fish and chips. Anyway, beautiful morning, let's go for a ride. As you can see, it's a misty morning up on the mountain, pretty chilly overnight, but we managed to stay warm. And the roads could be a bit slippery, so we're just going to ride nice and steady and admire the scenery. Roads like these, ideal Himalayan territory, I'll tell you. Perfect bike for this. Lovely scenery. What a lovely cracking day, we're lucky with the weather. A bit cold though, hands are cold, but the scenery makes up for it. So we're approaching the memory serves. This is the car park which takes you to the lower, or to the southern edge of Llyne Briane. So it's worth having a look at. Our route's then going to go skirt round the outskirts of Llyne Briane, and we're going to then ride down Devil's Staircase. I reckon the reservoir's risen 12 foot in the last week. We're going to move around now. We've moved from this location to another part of Lake Llyne Briane. I had to change the old gloves. Thicker gloves, they're warmer. The other ones were a bit damp and cold. So I hope I can still actuate the camera safely. Thank you.
feeling we're going down. It's a 25%, so 1 in 4. We're going down the Devil's Staircase. This is not difficult. It's not a difficult piece of road, actually. As long as you take your time. You've got good brakes. Basically, it's just two switchbacks. Just stick it in second gear and just tickle down nice and gentle. Lovely views into the Abergwesyn Valley beyond. Not that the GoPro would be showing it much, but I can see some wonderful views. Absolutely beautiful area. So we're on the Devil's Staircase now. This is one of the switchbacks, quite steep, but it's not difficult. And this is the other switchback. Let's have a look at them behind coming down. There's Harry and Dickie. Beautiful views into Abergwesyn. Yeah, we're on a bit of a back road heading towards Aberystwyth, and then we come across soon the most remote phone box in Wales. If you look on Google Maps, you'll see it says remote phone box, and that's along this road at some point. I must say though, using the long stroke chuggability of the engine to chug me up the hills, lovely up here. I know there's an area in Wales which is called Plym Limon or Plum Limon, and I got a feeling this is sort of part of that area. It's a sort of a wilderness remote area, and as you can see, it is pretty remote. Ah, I can see it. I can see it. The most remote phone box in Wales and post box. We're just approaching it. I've been looking on the Google map at this for some time. I always experience a bit of joy when I find something that I've been wanting to see for a long time, and there it is. The most remote phone box in Wales. We were going to Aberystwyth, but we changed our minds. We're now going to go to the Elan Valley Visitor Centre. We had a lovely cafe back there we stopped at. Yeah, so we're going to the Elan Valley Visitor Centre. I'm now in a place called Tregaron, by the way. Yeah, I'll take a look at Tregaron. Lovely place. So we decided to go to Elan Valley Visitor Centre. Some nice riding out that way. And also back there was a spa shop. Managed to get my favourite beer, Butty Back. It's absolutely lovely beer, that is. So I'm looking forward to this evening drinking some of that. Just gone past a sign which says Village of the Bards. This was a stronghold, I think, for the old what they call it, bards, novates and druids and what have you, back in the day before the Romans came. So quite what it's about, I'm not sure. Make sure it's clear behind. There, an old petrol station. In fact, quite an interesting old set of buildings there. Just past the signpost for Cwmystwyth, which is a lovely little back road on our way to the Elan Valley. I'm not sure if we go past the lead mine or not on this route. But this is where we are. We're at Cwmystwyth. Well, we are coming to the lead mines. Oh, this is a nice place to stop. Lovely place to stop. What's happened, the dams are very, very low. Well, this top dam's very, very low, and I think there's work going on upstream. They're draining the dam down, or draining the reservoir down so they can do some work on the dam, I think. But it really is very, very low.
That's
it. Well, we're back at the campsite now, and we've been greeted by a nice gift. One of the people here that's got a lodge, he's kindly brought us something. Ian, you've been very generous. Thank you very much. He invited us to his lodge last night, and he looked after us well. Sorted out our breakfast for us this morning, and we've come back, and he's left us a little treat for this evening. Right, sorry about the background noise. That's Harry. He won't shut up. So this is where all the noise is coming from. What have you got to say for yourself?
I'm a northerner, and I can't help it.
Tonight I've got stag chili. Yeah, that'll do, Harry. Oh, you don't want to come out. But anyway, stag chili with basmati rice. Yeah. I'm happy with that. Look at that. Look, that's really. That's how it's really.
It looks like dog food.
It does, doesn't it? Right.
After a hard day's riding, you can't beat stag chili.
Might as well all go in together.
There was cleaning sheds out of summer, and then the one that was doing kid hasn't got any patience. Wants everything done now.
The thing is, though, as you know.
Listen to that. It's hammering down. Oh.
Enjoying these coffee bags. They make a nice brew. Let's leave that for a minute or two. This is our last day here, and we're aiming to go to a mock German village on the military ground. Apparently we can't stop there, but we can ride past it, and then beyond that there's a lovely viaduct which I might be able to put the drone up on. This camera is getting very low now on SD card space, so quite what I'm going to be able to record, I'm not sure. I'll do my best. We've really just been bimbling around on these bikes, especially the road conditions after the rain, and the with leaves beginning to come off the trees now. I mean, the road's very slippery. And we're just bimbling, nice and steady. I mean, I'm doing 20-25 mile an hour. You don't need to go fast to see, to enjoy yourself on a motorcycle. And something else, don't need an expensive machine either. So many people have gone out and bought expensive motorcycles, planning to have an adventure. And yeah, they got the nice bike, but they never get the adventure because they spent all the money on the bike. So I think there's a moral in that story. Whatever bike you got is good enough. Anyway, look at the views. We're on the military road head, open to the public, unless otherwise stated. So yeah. We're on the military road. Red flag is flying. So can we proceed? Road open, it says. So the road open. Do not stop. Follow the signs, keep to the road. Looks like we can go, can't we?
It's open.
Open, yeah.
Might get shot.
Yeah, let's hope not. Right, we go for it then, yeah? Okay.
Do not stop, it says. And the microphone for this camera's failed, so I don't even know if you can hear me now. But anyway, I think we're almost at the end of the journey now along this piece of military road. The next place I want to see is the viaduct, and then I think that'd be the end of the video, and one camera down.
Well, unfortunately, the GoPro camera's defunct, the microphone lead is broke. So this will be the last clip that I'll do, because we're looking at having some rain later on this afternoon. So I'm just going to put the drone up on this lovely viaduct here, and then we're going to head back before the rain sets in. And just enjoy the afternoon, have a coffee and cake and stuff like that, you know. And then tomorrow we'll pack up and head home again. So I'll make this the sort of end of the video almost. As I say, we're going to put the drone up, get a view of the video, get a view of the viaduct from the air, and then that'll be the end of the video.
Anyway, let me show you how devilly handsome I am without my owl hood, see?
Well, Harry, it's been a pleasure to share the journey with you.
It's been excellent, mate, excellent.
I've really enjoyed these last few days. Yeah, yeah.
Thank you for the invite, yeah. And hopefully we can do it again.
I reckon so. You're part of the crew, aren't you?
I need to get a bigger tent.
You do. You need a bigger tent.
Other than that, I'm okay.
Dickie, before I'm going to put the drone up, and that'll be the final clips. There he is. Look, Dickie's thinking about starting up a YouTube channel.
Oh, no.
Right, so
Watch out for Dickus.
He's not really into big subscribers or getting all that sort of thing. He just wants to do his own thing. Well, and if he does start it up, I'll put a link in the description to his video.
He's very shy.
He's not really.
I am shy, yeah.
He's very shy.
Dickie is, for me, motorcycling is just a facet of what I do. For Dickie, it's his life. Isn't it, mate?
But I've only got one brain cell, so one channel thing it is with me.
And I'm just the lonely
thing. Yeah. So anyway, if he does start a channel, it'd be motorcycles, motorcycles, and motorcycles.
Yeah. Might have a bit of gardening.
Painting and decorating. So anyway, bye for now. Thanks for watching. Really appreciate you watching. Let's get the drone up and have a look at this lovely viaduct.